Nurse Sue here, and welcome to my kitchen. Today I'm going to show you how to make two ingredient dough. Super simple and easy, and this is Weight Watcher friendly. I know if you've done Weight Watchers, you've probably seen this recipe out there. I saw the recipe recently and I thought, gosh, I have never tried that. I want to give that a shot. So I made it and I did the bagels, and they're really good. I'm really surprised at how quick and easy they are and how good they are. So what we're going to start with in the bowl is 1 1/3 cups of flour. Now I will tell you, the recipe calls for 1 1/3 cups of self-rising flour. I don't have self-rising flour, and I am not going to go to the store and buy self-rising flour just for this recipe. I like to use what I have in my kitchen and in my pantry. I don't like to spend money for stuff that I may or may not use again, or it might take me a while to use it up. So I'm going to make my own self-rising flour. So that was just 1 1/3 cups of regular all-purpose flour. So to make it into self-rising flour, I'm going to take my baking powder and I'm going to add 1 1/2 teaspoons of that into my mix. And then I'm also going to add about 1/4 teaspoon of salt. And that's going to give me the self-rising effect that I need. So really simple. Okay, it's not 2 ingredients anymore, but whatever. Then the next thing I'm going to add is just some plain Greek yogurt. And I just buy the generic stuff, but you can get this massive tub at Costco for like $5. It's really not a bad price. And if you add honey to this, if you're eating it with like a fruit parfait or something, add some honey. It's really makes it more palatable. I'm not a plain yogurt fan, but this is not bad. So I just got that big one and I'm just going to put in 1 cup of plain yogurt. And that's it to the recipe, to be honest with you. I'm going to stir this, mix it up, knead it, all of that good stuff for about 1 to 2 minutes. And then after I've kneaded it for 1 to 2 minutes, I'm going to let it rest for 5 minutes. And then I'll divide the dough into 6 even portions because I'm making bagels. So I'm going to divide it into 6 pieces. So I'll have 6 bagels. I'm going to put them on my tray. And then I'll just pop them right into my air fryer and I'll have my bagels. The nice thing with this dough though is once you've had it made, you can do a lot of different things with it. You can make your rolls. You can, I would do a double batch and do pizza crust with it because it would be really good with that sauce and cheese and stuff on there. You can do cinnamon rolls if you wanted to do melt some butter, roll out your dough, melt some butter, and then do cinnamon sugar, roll it up like a cinnamon roll. So you have bagels, rolls, pizza crust, cinnamon rolls. You can just do a lot of different things and it's a super easy recipe, but I'm not going to take up your time where you watch me knead this for 2 minutes and then let it rest for 5 minutes. But what I'm going to do is after it rests for 5 minutes, I'll cut it into 6 even portions. I'll go ahead and make my bagels and then I'm going to spritz them with just a little bit of olive oil spray. And then I'm going to top them with the Everything Bagel Seasoning Mix. I'll put that on top of them, bake them in my air fryer. So I hope you try this recipe because if you like bread, like I like bread, but this is so much better for you than all of the other breads. And, you know, we know that bread is just not good for you if you eat a lot of it. So maybe I'll give this recipe a try. Let me know what you think of it. And thanks for stopping by my kitchen today.